My heart goes out to Dr. Claire Bailey Mosley and her family and their friends, of course. Just really, really sad to lose such a great man. And I think that's the main thing about these tributes to Michael Mosley. Everybody has been saying what great work he did. Yes, as a broadcaster, he was extremely talented, but also what he was doing was just teaching us about our bodies, teaching us about the wider world. And I think there will be a lot of people watching now who are, yes, they did take one step towards making their lives healthier. And it was all thanks to the unique way in which Michael Mosley helped us understand things, not least because, of course, he experimented on his own body in order to demonstrate the points that he wanted to make. So a great communicator, and absolutely tragic that he has been lost to his family and to the wider world at such a young age. He had so much more to give.
It really is so sad. And I mean, it does highlight the dangers if you are somewhere unfamiliar, the things that you must make sure that you have with you. Because I was so upset listening, thinking, I wish that he'd taken a mobile phone. I was thinking, oh, what if, you know, this, you know, his wife must be devastated. If you are somewhere unfamiliar, what are the main things that you need to make sure, especially in that kind of heat, that you take with you?
Can I just say that I am absolutely in tune with how he was feeling and the decision that he made. It might be seen as irresponsible. And of course, with hindsight, we can all look back and say, yes, of course, he should have had his phone with him. Yes, he should have made sure he had plenty of water. And ideally, he should have been hiking with somebody else, since he was, as his wife says, taking a really challenging hike. However, he was the sort of person who was very, very good at understanding risks, at knowing the issues that he could possibly face. And I can just see that it's a beautiful day. Yes, it's hot, but he's confident in his own abilities because he's shown time and time again that he's a great survivor. So I can see that he would set off like this. I think all of us, looking at the terrain that there is, the extreme heat, which currently is affecting Simi and other parts of the Eastern Mediterranean, you would, I think now, think again and consider, am I properly equipped? Have I got all I need in case there's a fall or I feel weak or whatever? But ultimately, it's a beautiful island. It was a fine day. He felt that he wasn't far from safety. It was just, I'm so sorry to say, misadventure. Something went tragically wrong, and it has ended with the loss of a great husband, a great father, and a great communicator who helped us all improve our health.
And those tributes are pouring in this morning, Simon. He does seem to be adored, not only as a doctor, as a professional, but as a person as well, very highly regarded. There are questions on many of the papers, and he really is on every front page of the papers this morning, but questions being asked about why it took so long to find him. Why was it a five-day search operation? And we know that it was a very intense one. What can you tell us about the terrain on the island that might have made that quite complicated for people searching for Michael?
Those of us who've been lucky enough to go to these Greek islands, the really quite extreme east ones close to the Turkish mainland, will know that they are characterized by being very hilly, very rocky. There's very rough scrub there. It is a difficult area to search. Yes, we knew roughly where he was heading, but ultimately, and I've done this, my goodness, and I genuinely thought there, but for fortune go I. I've been in the position of having making a decision about walking in the hills. I do quite a lot of walking and climbing. And on my own, I can see that I could quite possibly do the same. And very, very sadly, we now know the result after, of course, days of hoping that there would be some other explanation for it. But it's a wide and difficult area. Yes, they were bringing in drones to help with the search, but ultimately, if somebody goes missing and they don't, you've got no way of tracking him apart from really quite some CCTV footage, which doesn't really tell you very much, then I'm afraid it is just a matter of keeping looking until, well, the terrible moment yesterday when his body was found. So, so sad. And my I hope is that the family of Dr. Michael Mosley will take comfort from the fact that he was in a wonderful location and that he was with the people he loved. And like many people over the years, he was just unlucky.